The two other main parts of a tropical cyclone are the eyewall and the rainbands, where thunderstorms exist within the hurricane. Surrounding the eye of the storm resides the eyewall, a thick cloud layer around the eye. In this region of the hurricane, winds essentially are at maximum speeds and determine intensity levels of the storm. Beyond the eyewall, towards the outer edges of a tropical cyclone, rainbands thrive and may expand a few hundred miles from the center. Characterized as dense bands of thunderstorms that spiral slowly counterclockwise, there are chances for heavy bursts of rain and wind, and the possibility of tornado formation. Between rainbands, there can be areas where no rain or wind is found. In intense tropical cyclones, rainbands can organize into an outer ring of thunderstorms that encroach on the center of the storm, robbing the inner eyewall of moisture and momentum. This causes the tropical cyclone to begin weakening. The Super Typhoon Tip in 1979, the most enormous storm ever recorded, extended over 675 miles in radius. The smallest storm, Tropical Storm Marco, in 2008 reached a diameter of 23 miles. The winds of a tropical cyclone can extend even further than the storm itself. Blown away by this week's topic? Tune in next Wednesday at noon as we explore the classification and naming of these massive storms. Subscribe to Mr. Weather's World on YouTube for videos every Weather Wednesday.